Wait, what happened?
I don't know.
Someone asked, what's your rising sign?
I think we got kicked off. We've been on this too long.
Does that happen?
Yeah. Instagram's a hater. They want you to go live, but then they want to limit how long you're on there.
Oh, that's annoying.
Let me see your brow.
Like this?
Yeah, extend her. You can pull her out a little more at the end, okay, too.
Wow, this is a full-on RuPaul Drag Race eyebrow.
Ooh! Even snatch her even more at the corner. Yeah, like, make her a little longer. Why not? Yes.
Okay.
Gorgeous. And depending on the look, sometimes I like a brushy, bushy eyebrow, and sometimes I like it really tapered.
Okay, what are you doing tonight?
I'm gonna do a middle, an in between.
Okay, so you said you normally don't use pencil. Why use pencil tonight?
Because we're getting crazy.
Oh, okay, got it. I was wondering if there was any other reason.
No, just because we feel like being, you know, different.
Spontaneous.
I want to test my limits.
Okay, how's that?
Gorgy. You're going to have to put more white in the middle here.
Oh, I know, I'm trying to. It's just like that fucking Kmart white eyeshadow.
We're working with what we got, babe.
Try this one more time. Okay. Oh, wait, I just got it to work, I think.
Are you spiritual? Do you read any books? Do you meditate?
I read my horoscopes on dailyhoroscopes.com.
And are they usually accurate?
It's actually freakingly accurate.
Which one's daily? I feel like that's the one that's actually accurate.
It's the one by Susan Miller.
Yes.
It's so there's an app that I just downloaded just every morning and send it to you.
And her day, because I've only ever read her monthly horoscopes.
Yeah, she has daily ones. I mean.
But do you feel like if you read something that's like negative, will it impact your day?
No, I read it the night before, actually. Like, it gives me the next day, and I read it, and so it kind of, like, sometimes I'm like, oh, what could that be about? You know what I mean? And it kind of helps me, like, prep for it in a weird way. So I try
Capricorn,
to find the positive
Capricorn
in it.
Energy. Love to be prepped. Love to
work. I was like, let me be prepared.
Prepared for the next day, for the challenges. Yeah, I used to read daily horoscopes, and then when I found that, like, I don't know, whenever I read something that was negative,
it just, like, weighed on you?
No, I just ignored it. So then I'm like, why am I reading this?
Yeah, like, if it's negative, like, filling your brain with, like, stupid thoughts.
Yeah, if it's negative, I'm just like, no. Yeah. No.
That's, like, the, like, love-hate relationship. It's, like, having, like, you know, the desire to kind of, like, be curious, but also then being like, well, if it's negative or it's bad, then, like, what the fuck? Do you know what I mean?
But I think it's also a really good exercise, like, training your brain to not allow, like, reading something negative to affect you or change your mood or your day. Yeah. And it's also kind of training your mind to, like, take something negative and flip it and make it positive rather than just like sulking in that and going with what it's telling you.
Yeah.
So you can look at it like that too.
That's true. No, I try to always, of course, find the, you know, the light in the darkness.
Wait, somebody asked earlier, what are your inspirations?
For me?
Mm-hmm.
Gosh, it's like, everything and anything. It's, I love, like, I mean, like, there's just recently, like, I've been really, really, like, the last three, like, 2 or 3 years, I've been really, really inspired by a lot of, like, my cultural upbringing, because it was something that I was never really going through, like, boarding school was something that I was never really, like, privy to, you know, growing up, you know, understanding, like, where my parents came from, how they, like, got to the, you know, the States, and, you know, what was their life before me, and all of that, so, like, this kind of sense of, like, my obsession with, like, neoclassical Americana, you know what I mean? Like, when I think about, like, the great American designers, whether it's Ralph or Calvin, and kind of, like, what inspired their path, you know, like, what is it about Americana that relates and resonates with me, and, you know, and the things that I tend to kind of love about, you know, whether it's, like, super lo-fi or, you know, ordinary or banal, you know, and to, the, and then trying to make it aspirational and exciting, you know. So
have you been using, like, have you been studying your culture more and, like, your parents and your grandparents' history? And are you, like, infusing some of those?
Okay. It's totally been this kind of, like, culture clash that I've been really, really, you know, kind of interrogating, you know, even just, like, asking my mom, like, I'm, like, I went home to Shanghai, like, a year ago, and my mom, like, showed me all these old photos that I've never seen before, you know, when she was younger, and it was just, like, I got really emotional, because I was, like, oh, my gosh, I felt like I was, like, learning about my mom all over again, you know what I mean? Or my parents and my siblings and everything like that, so it was,
Because I think growing up, were you born here? Were you born?
Yeah, I was born in San Francisco, and I was, like, my mom had me when she was 40, so I was kind of, like, an accident. And I have an older brother and sister who are, like, 17 years older, so 15 and 17 years older, so they had, like, a whole life before me, and, like, in Taiwan and in China, and so...
I love Taiwan. Taiwan is a fucking party.
Like, Taiwan was first Asian country to allow gay marriage.
Really?
And yeah. So it's, like, super open, super, like, you know, liberal. The food's amazing.
The food is incredible.
Yeah.
Everyone is so nice. I went to this club there that was, like, massive, like, 5 floors. And there were these girls, like, performing with, they had, like, alcohol bottles that were on fire.
Bottle girls. Oh, wait, what were you there for?
But it was a full performance. It wasn't just, like, bottles. It was, like, a full choreographed performance.
Obsessed.
Like, Taiwan is insane. I love it. I love it there.
Were you working there?
I was. So, you know, in high school when I...
Oh, yeah, you did the glasses.
Yeah, I did my sunglasses, and I had Japanese investors. So I was flying to, like, Japan, Hong Kong, China, Taiwan... So I really got to, like, experience all of these places, like, at a really young age, and it was just crazy, but it was so fun. I think it's really important to tap into your culture, because I think being born in America, like, you can definitely get caught up and, like, not really even take the time to understand, like, your ancestry or your...
Yeah, and that, I'm guilty of it. That was me, like, you know, when I was younger and growing up, until, like, I reached an age where I was like, fuck, there's so much... There's so much rich history, and, you know, and that I never even took the effort to kind of really dig into. Mm-hmm. And, you know, it wasn't until, like, I, you know, like, even I'd say probably, like, 7 years ago that I really, you know, really went into that phase, you know.
And probably so much beauty, because I think there's so much beauty and, like, culture everywhere else that we in America, like, tend to, like, grab onto and inspiration. And so I feel like you tapping into that, especially with your designs, like, there's probably so many beautiful textiles and, like, just imagery that you can use.
Yeah. No, so much. I mean, hold on 1 second. Let me go get my phone cord, because my phone's about to die.
Oh, your phone's going to die? Okay. And we probably should get back to this beat. I don't know where these are from, and I'm sorry.
Okay, hold on. Let's get this.
Let's get into some concealer, and then we can go back to the eyes.
Ah, we are back in business. Okay, great. Okay, where are we? What are we doing with the concealer?
Show me your eyes, left and right. Yeah. Okay, go back. Can you darken this black bottom really quickly? And then let's go in with some concealer.
Yeah, I definitely started melting
Hunty.
Off.
Hunty's here.
Hunty, who's Hunty?
Hunter.
Let me see Hunter.
Hunty, no, she was writing something.
Oh.
She's not here.
I thought Hunter was your dog or something. Hunter Schaefer.
I can't have people over. I'm being a good girl. What brush do I want to use?
Okay. How's that?
Beautiful. Okay, what let's go in with concealer.
Okay.
You want to be careful around the line.
Okay. I'm using a stick, so I'm using my fingers.
Perfect.
Is it just under eye right now?
Yes. Have you been working at all, or are you just resting?
No, I've been working, to the best of our effort, you know? Like,
yeah.
Zoom calls and, like,
oh my god, fucking Zoom.
Proving things on, like, it's hard, though, because it's, like, I mean, obviously in a certain part when you can't, like, work with your pattern maker or your sewer and, you know.
Are you super hands-on?
I'm super hands-on. I mean, obviously I have a team that I really depend on and we work really closely together, but I love the fitting process because, like, that's the part where my favorite part is, like, putting things into work when you don't know exactly what the outcome is going to be, and then, like, coming into the fitting process where you're just, like, being spontaneous and improvising and cutting things apart, and then you, like, realize, like, you know, like, you kind of figure it, like, that's the fun part about the design and creative process for me, so...
So that must, that's hard. You can't do any of that right now. You know, I was obsessed with your brand, like, when I was in, like, high school. I remember my aunt was, like, really into fashion, and she took me to opening ceremony.
Uh-huh.
And I had never seen, like, fashion like that in person. And I actually cried.
Aww.
Like, I cried being in there because it was just so beautiful, and I was obsessed with your stuff, but I could never afford it.
Well, I'm going to send you a little care package after this.
Oh, you don't have to. I just always, always, always loved it. I remember, like, looking up, like, where you studied and, like, what you did. And
so
what,
cute.
Yeah.
Well, look at us. Reunited.
Look at us now, bitch.
You're teaching me.
Wait, let me see. Beautiful. Let's do a little above the brow.
Okay. Oh, concealer?
Yes.
Okay.
To define her.
Okay, my face is totally getting red from drinking, but it's okay.
It's okay. You're giving a sexy flush.
Sexy flush. Oh, I like that. It's like a
sexy flush.
Like a just
sexy
after
flush with
sex
wing.
Look.
Sexy flush with wing.
That's literally, if I had a makeup line, that's what it would be.
Sexy flush with wing.
Yeah.
Or by wing.
Okay.
Do you ever contour?
I've done when I have, like, you know, for, like, Halloween or whatnot on a daily basis, but tell me, what do we do? What are we doing?
We're going to do a subtle contour because I'm not a contour type of bitch.
Okay.
But first, let's set our under eyes. So get translucent powder.
Okay.
And just dab the powder under the eyes.
Okay. Oh my god. Who's coming over? Seamless.
Who's coming over?
I don't know. I'm just saying, like, what are we gonna look forward to after this? Like, the food
delivery. I'm gonna sit here just staring at myself for an hour and then.
You're like, I'm gonna sit here.
Or I'm gonna FaceTime everyone I know just because I have makeup on.
Okay.
What are you doing?
Wait, me? Or are you saying when you were calling your friend?
When I FaceTime everyone. Oh. Did you set her?
Yeah, I set her.
Wow, beautiful. Okay. What do you have for contour?
I have a bronzer and a blush.
Okay, let's get the bronzer.
Okay.
I'm going to try this. I've never tried it before, but...
Ooh, what is that?
It's a contour.
Oh, the brush. Contour. Oh, it's like that. Oh, wow.
Yeah, there's a brush here.
That's cool.
Okay.
Fancy.
Do your cheekbone.
Okay. Underneath, right?
Yes.
Shit, I think this color's too light. It's not showing up on me.
Really?
Yeah.
I need to beat your face when we're out of this and I can do it on you.
Yes. That's face two.
Face two. Okay, I'm gonna blend this.
Okay.
See?
Okay, well, this is, I feel like it's all getting in my hairline.
I actually love this product.
Okay. Hold on. I'm going to use the blush because that one wasn't working.
Okay. Where'd our music go?
Oh, sorry. Oh, Usher, I think it makes me wanna.
You make me wanna leave the one I'm with.
I know this is a remix. Okay.
Gorgeous. Okay, so now let's powder full face.
Okay.
Do you like to be dewy?
Yeah, I do.
Then just do a really light.
Okay. Oliver? Okay. Yeah.
Copy me, babe. Gorgeous. You look hot. Okay.
Okay.
Let's do a little blush.
Okay. Let me put that on, but I'll do it again. Ooh. Okay.
Got it?
Where do you put it? I want to see where you put it. Okay. The top close to the cheek. Okay. Okay.
Beautiful. Okay, let's go in with mascara.
Okay.
Do you have one?
Yeah.
I like to do this.
Oh, that's a campaign right there.
Free campaign.
I have the smallest eyelashes, but we'll make do.
So do I, it's fine.
How do you do the bottom?
Like this, hold on. Ugh, it gets so messy. Like this.
Ooh, okay, a little zigzag, okay.
I hope you got lip liner.
I did. I knew that was really important. The brown lip liner.
Yep.
Brings me back to high school.
Love it. I never lost.
Okay.
Are you done with your eyelashes?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. I'm not.
Okay, it's fine. I'll just drink.
Just drink while I do my lashes. 7 drinks later.
I think I'm like on my 7th. Yeah, I am on my 7th.
Oh my god. I would drink 1 and be done. Mm. Woo! Okay.
Okay.
I'm gonna go in with 1 more mascara because I'm...
Ooh, like a double duty?
Yeah, I'm doing a double.
Okay, I'll do it with you since I have nothing else to do.
Just get them real, as fluffy as we can. Okay.
Okay, real spidery, but it's okay.
Let's go, bitch. Lip liner.
Lip liner, okay. What do you draw, like, on the outside of your lips?
I do, like, honestly, right on it.
Okay.
Like, that line there.
Yeah.
That's where I do it.
And you do, like, you go into the divot, right? Because I know a lot of girls don't go into that, but I'm
You just know kidding. What? You know what? I used to hide this. Like, I used to do that. And then
yeah.
I like it. Why am I doing that?
Like, okay.
Why am I shaming my stupid foe?
Well, at least this lip liner is good.
Ooh.
I was like, oh, Kmart got some good lip liner.
That's a fucking good one.
It's really creamy and soft.
Told you, Kmart is like, they have good lip liners.
They do. I mean, shit. Okay, I'm proud of the lip liner.
Okay, you got lipstick?
Yes.
All right, then. Let's go in with some lipstick.
Okay. Ooh, I got some cat lips.
Why are you dry? Why are your lips dry? I'm gonna put a little gloss.
Okay, clear?
Clear.
Okay.
You've done your makeup Voila. Before. You're way too good. Hold on.
What do you think?
You're way too good at this. You practice.
Alexa, I would not go on live unless I practiced.
You practice, man! Wow, you look hot.
Oh my god, you guys. Bathroom party. Are we done?
Do we want to be done? Let me see. Come close. We're done.
Oh. Wow.
Do you want to be like, let's be crazy.
Okay. Tell me, what are we doing?
Do a little, like, beauty mark on your
Okay. Head. Okay. Okay. Ooh, okay. Like, on the lip liner? On the lip?
Yeah.
Not with black?
I have, like, a brown, dark brown.
Oh, okay. Here, let me do the... Here, you know what? I'll make mine black. Since, you know, such a...
Bitch, all this makeup. Now what?
Now what? Now let's call Seamless. Let's call Caviar. It's called delivery.
Have you been getting delivery?
No, no one delivers out here in like the forest, so.
Oh, you're so lucky you're in the forest.
I've just been cooking, you know, cooking my ass off.
Same, bitch. I swear, I'm opening a restaurant.
What are you having tonight?
Ooh, what am I having? I don't know. The possibilities are, you know, I've been getting all my groceries at a farm.
Like recently? Like during this pandemic?
Yeah.
How?
There's a farm that's like 20, 30 minutes from me and my friend told me about and no one really goes. And it's just an open farm and you go pick like the freshest produce.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's really nice. Do you have like a rose water spray or something?
I do. Oh, thank you for reminding me. Love a doobie. Okay.
Let's give her a spritz.
The finishing touch.
We just did like 50 squirts.
I told you I like it wet.
Wait, same. We gotta go out with a song.
Wait, I gotta tell everyone, first of all, thank you so much. You know, this was scary as hell, but I thought it was really important that we create some entertainment for all our fans and people watching to, you know, stay positive, but also stay in, and hopefully you guys had fun watching tonight. We're really excited. We're also launching a sale, 72-hour sale on Monday, benefiting the World Health Organization. So I'm really humbled and want to thank all the, you know, healthcare workers and the first responders, you know, out there. They are our heroes. And again, you know, just trying to do the little bit that we can to contribute. And I want to thank you, Alexa, so much because you have made this so much fun and I love you. I can't wait to see you and give you a huge hug. Yeah.
Well, now I just have to say, my little sister is launching her brand soon, but she's making masks for hospitals and for people who need them, and we're going to be shipping them for free. So if you DM me your name and address, I will get you a mask.
Wow.
And yeah, this is like a really scary time, and we're all really just unsure and keep hearing different things, and we don't really know when this is going to be over, but hopefully this, you know, brought you a little bit of joy.
Yeah.
And laughter. For a moment. Oh, let me do a card.
Oh yeah, pull a card. Alexa's okay. Gonna pull a card right now for me. Because
I'm gonna pull it for you and then I'm gonna pull it for the world.
Oh yeah, pull it for the world, yes, please. We need a, hopefully it's positive. Ooh.
There's these that are really intense.
Okay.
And then I have fairies. Goddess.
Okay.
My angel ones are in the car because I
take them with me. Whatever, I trust you. Whatever ones you feel like are the vibe.
You know what? I'll pull this separately and text you because they're like really long explanations.
Okay.
For now, let's do one of these.
Okay.
Just pick.
The fairy one.
Yay! You're a fairy. Okay. So get... Tune in.
Okay. Hold on, let me turn off the music. Hold on.
Turn off the music. Yeah.
Alexa. Hey, Alexa.
Fuck no. You don't have an Alexa.
The other Alexa.
Stole my name. Okay. Get centered. Get grounded.
Okay.
Think of your higher self connecting with my higher self. And just think of something that... you know, is you know, something you want to know, a feeling that's been lingering, just anything you want. Or if you just want a message, period. From
Can I keep it? Do I have to say it out loud?
No.
Okay.
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 Tell me when you're ready.
I'm ready.
How many cards do you want?
I don't know. I've never done this. So however many you think I need to, like, you know.
Okay, I'm picking.
Okay.
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 It got serious.
Oh, I know. We turned off the music.
Wow. So the first one is Magic of Nature.
Ooh, okay.
Let me read it. It's interesting because you got Magic of Nature and then you got Environmental Awareness.
Hmm. Okay. Which,
you know, something we're all. So it says, Magic of Nature, spend time outdoors among the flowers, plants, and trees. Nature has powerful gifts that she wants to share with you, including ideas, information, and healing energy. Do you ever sit outside or go by the trees? Or
it's so funny. I never get to when I'm in the city. You know what I mean? Because you're just like always in like the rat cage. But part of the reason, like, I left really early to be out here was just because I wanted to be closer to nature and, like, you know, go on a walk in the forest and all of that. And I've been doing that. I've been doing, like, bike rides. And it's been really, you know, different. But I love it. You know what I mean? Because it's so not my regular thing. So it's interesting that that was the question.
And you got this. And honestly, like, we don't realize it. But, like, in nature, when I'm just kind of, like, letting go of everything and just laying on the grass, like by the trees, like it's honestly when I get a lot of ideas and I feel like I get like a wave of healing, like nature has that. We just never like tap into it because we're always like so go, go, go.
Yeah.
So basically by drawing this card, you're being urged to spend time daily, even as little as 5 minutes outside in nature. Remove your shoes. Socks.
Okay.
Connect your bare feet with the soil, sod, or sand. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths as you're surrounded by the magical energy of nature. Mentally ask for help with any issues and then open your eyes and look for flitting light, which is the first sign that you're seeing like fairies or energy, like healing energy, basically.
Yeah.
So good. You're already doing
it. Oh, I love it. Thank you.
Of course. Let's read the next one.
Okay.
Environmental awareness. Ooh. I'm shook.
Shit, that scared me.
It says that the fairy kingdom is very concerned with the health of Mother Earth.
Okay.
Which kind of explains, like, we went through this whole period with all the fires, and now this, and, like, clearly, you know.
We have issues.
We have issues, and we're not good to Earth, and I think it's a little bit of a wake-up call. But you, Alexander Wang, you have the power to make a huge impact on our planet.
Fuck, the pressure. Okay.
Earth is a living, breathing being, and they're calling upon you to help her. Your contributions could include recycling, picking up trash, getting involved in an environmental protection group, becoming a vegetarian, or just educating other people on environmental issues. So just, what can we do for our planet?
Okay, I think I got that. I can.
You got it?
I can handle that. I don't know about vegetarian, but I'm trying.
You don't have to be vegetarian. You know, there's other ways. The last part is look inside yourself. You've been trying to find satisfaction through outside sources, such as material possessions or relationships. We are not asking you to look within for the answers that you need. Sometimes when you feel empty, your first reaction is to try and fill up the emptiness by acquiring something or someone. I'll be happy when I have this, or I'll be happy when I do that. Basically, there's nothing wrong with that, you know, and I'm trying to shorten this, sorry.
Yeah.
Basically, you have great beauty and light inside of you, and especially right now in this time where, like, you are by yourself or you aren't seeing that many people, I think right now is time to, like, tap into yourself.
Yeah.
And just, I don't know, I think beautiful things and ideas and intuitions come when you really, like, pause.
Yeah, no, that's so true.
Sorry, I'm getting deep, bitch, and you're, like, 7 wines in. You're, like, stop.
I'm like, I need a refill.
You're like, no, bitch, I just need another wine.
Oh, I love you so much.
I love you. This was so much. Honestly, this brought me like a lot of joy because I've been kind of, you know, up and down.
Yeah, no, and this is so much fun. It really, like, I had so much fun. We've been on this for 1 hour and 40 minutes now.
Bitch.
Wait, I need to get a screenshot of this. Hold on, let me see. Wait, how am I going to do this? Wait, someone do a screenshot of this and DM it to us. Okay, hopefully someone got that.
Are you screenshotting this? They got it.
Okay.
DM us the screenshots, please.
Please.
And if you want to create this look, tag us or send it to us. Show
yes,
us.
Yes, please. Show it to us. We're so excited.
And I'm sure Alex is going to be doing a lot more of these, and we're all going to be tuning in.
No, we're so excited. This is the first one. You popped my cherry.
Love that. I love to pop the cherry.
Bye.
Okay,
have fun. Tell me what you end up doing later.
I will.
Bye.
Bye. How do I get out of here? I'm an idiot.